Coke LaRock. Most people outside of the Bronx, myself included, first heard the name Coke LaRock in 1986 on KRS-One's classic South Bronx record. But Coke had already made history and established a legacy, first in the streets and later on the turntables and the mic over a decade before. The man widely known as the first MC was originally a DJ who touched the turntables for the first time while he was filling in for his childhood friend Cool Herc, who needed to take a break. Herc and Coke were friends as teenagers long before they laid the foundation for the worldwide subculture now known as hip-hop. The friendship continued once they became DJs, and Coke has said that anyone speaking of hip-hop that mentions DJ Cool Herc and does not mention Coke LaRock, you must not have been there. Coke LaRock, versions of the name have reverberated through rap music over the years. T LaRock, Star Child LaRock, Scott LaRock immediately come to mind. But Coke says that his name came to him in a dream that involved some Mexican drug lords and some other underworld things that we don't want to incriminate nobody here, so we're not going to talk about that. But Coke's first nickname was Coco because his mother used to put cocoa in his milk when he was an infant. So Coke, you know, that's the gradual transformation of that name, started as Coco. So as hip-hop has debate in 2021 whether a freestyle means off the top of the head or what it originally meant, Coke LaRock said he never wrote a rhyme down. So this dude, he was Jay-Z and Biggie and everybody else who doesn't write long before these guys were barely born. Never wrote anything down. The pioneering Bronx MCs that I've had the pleasure of talking to always name one or two entities as their inspiration to MC, either Coke LaRock or Keith Cowboy, Melly Mel, and Kid Creole, the three MCs. That's usually the names that come up. When I asked Mel and Creole, well, what's your inspiration? Of all these cats inspired by you, what's your inspiration? They said emphatically, Coke LaRock. He is the architect who influenced the architects. Things that became the norm were born with Coke and Herc. Because stick-up kids would try to stick the DJs for the equipment, Coke and Herc were the first to put a rope between the crowd and the DJ. And that rope was also a warning perimeter that you could get shot if you came across that rope, because there was artillery on stage in case somebody, you know, wanted to step across that rope and try to help themselves with some equipment. Coke is also one of the fathers of the custom mixtape, charging $50 to hustlers back in the days for a custom 8-track tape, not even a cassette. So, you know, father of the custom mixtape on 8-track at that. From the Twilight Zone to the Executive Playhouse, the Parkside to the Hevelo, it's not a man that can't be thrown, a horse that can't be rode, a bull that can't be stopped, and there's not a Coke LaRock cannot rock. Coke LaRock.
Now way back in the
to thank everyone for all of this. I'd like to thank y'all for inducting me into something. You know, no disrespect. I don't hold no punches, no nothing. You know me. I'm Coke LaRock, a man of my own, never was a stepping stone. But again, thank you. This is a pleasure to me, you know, because I'm living hip-hop through a couple of people in my life right now, and my partner, Lucky Bling, my main man, Jack and Desiree. Jack is my artist. We do what we do. We had a club called LaRock's. We was doing our thing. And then again, let's get back to the beginning. A lot of cats, you know, you get caught up with how, who, and what place. If Herc came out of this room here, and I came out of this room here, then what place do I fit? Just like I say when they take your name, you know, It went from Coke LaRock, T LaRock, K LaRock, Scott LaRock, Doc LaRock, RC LaRock. They got about 90 LaRocks running around here. My son's middle name is LaRock. His name is Dante LaRock. He was born, and when I was at the Executive Playhouse, people wasn't even born then. And then again, I grew up, I thought, for at one time, you know, in the era of the Mac, that was my favorite movie, you know, Richard Pryor and my man. You go, we go get them, Goldie. I used to tell her that. We go get them, Goldie. We go get them niggas, Goldie. You know what I'm saying? So, but again, just growing up, man, like, it was a pleasure. I could see now hip-hop saved me. You know what I'm saying? I took it outside, inside. You know, and I did a lot, but enough to survive. And hip-hop itself, you know, like when you're saying everybody got like a place. But once again, I'm living it through my grandkids, you know, because the culture, like we said, they got to live it. And even talking, I can go real deep into a lot of areas about it, but they made me realize, you know, I thought drugs was legal. I ain't trying to be funny, you know. I thought it was legal. You know, the Nicky Barnes era and all that. And the guys, you know, it was $2 and $3. I thought, wow, what's that? You know, I went to church with grandma, come on Sunday. You know what I'm saying? You had three sets of clothes, dress clothes, school clothes, and church clothes. Let's get real. I grew up on the block. You couldn't cross the street. But when hip hop came, like I said before hip hop, I went to clubs. I went to a bunch of clubs. I was getting in clubs at 17 when I was 22, but I got in there due to my pocket. I mean, at the top of my game, I'm getting $1,700 a day, $30,000 a week. I mean, what are we talking about? You know, but once again, we're talking hip-hop, which I see it became a patent. I didn't write nothing. I didn't know nothing about this. But as a partner, as far as me and Cool Herc, the father of hip-hop, like I said, music and parties, and that's how it went. And then you see where it went now. Look, it's $1 billion around the world. And the cats that didn't get no due, I don't hold no grudges. I don't hold none of that. I'll be 66. How many in here be 66? I could be people's grandfathers, you know? But I get my love back now through who recognize me. You can know me or not know me. You know what I'm saying? And I love you for it. But if you don't know me, you don't know hip-hop. Let me let you know that. And in the last 2 years, I had two brothers that been, like, holding on to me, man. And I got to thank you, Geechee Dan, my brother. You're one of them. You're one of them, Geechee Dan, my brother. Thank you. Believing and holding on to Coke LaRock. Because like I told you, I'm a G-Money man, and you're a G-Money man. We keep a G or better any type of weather. And DJ K-Slate, he's not here, but thank you, K-Slate. K-Slate just put me on a track. He put me on a video. K-Slate been holding my hand. But not holding my hand like he's leading me. He's holding my hand, bringing me back where I need to be. He said, brush that old stuff off, Coke, because I got you. And that's where we at. All in management. Ricky, where my man Rick at? We here, baby. Rick got his shirts ready. You ready? Let's go. But I like to thank everybody that's involved with hip-hop because I am hip-hop. I'm born hip-hop. I'm a name creator, brain talker. Let me just tell you. I found out who I was. My brother came home from jail, and he said, Coach, all that you talk, you telling yourself. And I said, what? So he said, them rhymes you be saying, you talking about yourself. And I said, you know what? You're right. Because it went like this. I'm the first G-Money man. I kept a G or better any type of weather, cold or hot, rain or not. Born in an orphan, fought like a slave, chucking and fighting is all Coke LaRock played. Because if a freak is unique, and that's the freak you seek, I guess before you go, the freak be on the boat. Knowing the music not stopping, the rocks are dropping, the champagne is flowing, the freaks will be going. Hotel, motel, you don't tell, we don't tell. One time, let me introduce myself. I am Coke LaRock.
Way back in the days when hip-hop began, with Coke LaRock, rock, hurt me, then bam. Now way back in the days when hip-hop began, with Coke LaRock, rock, hurt me, then bam.